I want to share with you the two main reasons behind the killing of prophets. It is clear that in our time, the stoning of the prophet is no longer done as it used to be done with natural stones. But today we use different types of stones to kill our prophets. The king Ahab had married a woman, Jezebel, and Jezebel had killed all the prophets. Elijah thought that he was alone. Later on, God said that I have kept for myself 7,000, meaning the prophets that were alive by divine protection. Naturally, all the prophets died. There are two main reasons behind the killing of the prophets. The first reason why prophets are killed is because prophets are not understood. Misunderstanding. The second main reason why prophets are killed is because prophets stands often as a threat. The presence of a true prophet is threatening to the devil. And not only to the devil, but it's also threatening to the establishment, the religious establishment. Based on that, the prophet is a threat and is annoying and had to go. Prophets are misunderstood by most in their generation, and that leads to a total rejection of their work and often to an uproar against them. They are misunderstood by those who are, one, slaves of tradition. Their minds are in the box. They do not think beyond what was yesterday. Anytime a prophet comes, they cannot understand him. Now, in the time of Isaac did not understand the power of revelation, because you see, Isaac was still locked in tradition, the routines of life that had set that it is the firstborn that gets the blessing. Most of the people today who do not understand what is happening in the prophetic do so simply because of tradition. The lack of understanding, the confusion that the prophetic brings, is not because the prophetic is incorrect, but it's simply because they do not find the reference of it yesterday. There are a few things that you have to know, family. The first thing that you need to know is life evolves. Second thing you need to know is that the revelation in God is progressive. It comes to us gradually. Do you know that yesterday, having the instrument that we have in church today was a sign of the world in the church? Yesterday, you could not have a guitar in the church because they will say you are imitating the world. And most will come to you and say you are conforming to the patterns of this world, using biblical verses against you. People come to you and say it's not biblical. Where have you seen keyboard mentioned in the word? Television yesterday was an instrument of deception, of propaganda, an instrument of the devil in the world of yesterday. But yet today, we are standing in the church of God, preaching the gospel in television. But yesterday, there are people who have been expelled out of the church simply because they watch TV. Today, we advertise it. We say, watch, catch Pastor Alf on such and such a TV. And because you will always have those who feel, because of tradition, that they know all, they'll question you. Where did you see the word television in the Bible? The person saying that is wearing a tie. Ask him, where have you seen the word tie in the Bible? What is biblical is not merely written in the black and white. What is biblical is what is aligned with the spirit of the Bible. Revelation breaks tradition. Most of the prophets are not understood. First, because the mind of many is locked in the past. Every time there is a new thing, many will arise against it. They will attack it. Those of yesterday didn't see the move of the Holy Ghost as we see it today. Paul, the prince of the epistles, the prince of the New Testament, said, we know in part, and one day we will know as we have been known. Don't fall prey to your own mind when you are pushed to think that what you know is the absolute truth. Allow the Spirit of God daily to guide you. Allow the Spirit of God to take you from one step to another. The first reason why prophets are killed is because of misunderstanding. And one of the key causes of the misunderstanding that leads to the killing of prophets is because many are still locked in the tradition. They can see the power of God being demonstrated. They will still say, this is the devil or this is tricked. You can bring a dead person in pieces and stick the pieces together in front of them and pray for the person to come back. They'll say, this is magic. Because you see, is a mindset. It has nothing to do with what you do. No matter how hard you try to do it, they will never buy into it. They think they know. They think they are high. And the reference is yesterday. Is old news.